It is literally impossible to be a woman. You are so beautiful and so smart, and it kills me that you don't think you're good enough. Like, we have to always be extraordinary. But somehow we're always doing it wrong. Like, you have to be thin, but not too thin. And you can never say you want to be thin. You have to say you want to be healthy, but also you have to be thin. You have to have money, but you can't ask for money because that's crass. You have to be a boss, but you can't be mean. You have to lead, but you can't squash other people's ideas. You're supposed to love being a mother, but don't talk about your kids all the damn time. You have to be a career woman, but also always be looking out for other people. You have to answer for men's bad behavior, which is insane, but if you point that out, you're accused of complaining. You're supposed to stay pretty for men, but not so pretty that you tempt them too much or that you threaten other women, because you're supposed to be a part of the sisterhood, but always stand out and always be grateful. But never forget that the system is rigged, so find a way to acknowledge that, but also always be grateful. You have to never get old, never be rude, never show off, never be selfish, never fall down, never fail, never show fear, never get out of line. It's too hard, it's too contradictory, and nobody gives you a medal or says thank you. And it turns out, in fact, that not only are you doing everything wrong, but also everything is your fault. I'm just so tired of watching myself and every single other woman tie herself into knots so that people will like us. And if all of that is also true for a doll, just representing a woman, then I don't even know.
I'm not good enough for anything.
It is literally impossible to be a woman. You are so beautiful and so smart, and it kills me that you don't think you're good enough. Like, we have to always be extraordinary, but somehow we're always doing it wrong.
I'm not good enough for anything.
It is literally impossible to be a woman. You are so beautiful and so smart, and it kills me that you don't think you're good enough. Like, we have to always be extraordinary, but somehow we're always doing it wrong. Like, you have to be thin, but not too thin. And you can never say you want to be thin. You have to say you want to be healthy, but also you have to be thin. You have to have money, but you can't ask for money, because that's crass. You have to be a boss, but you can't be mean. You have to lead, but you can't squash other people's ideas. You're supposed to love being a mother, but don't talk about your kids all the damn time. You have to be a career woman, but also always be looking out for other people. You have to answer for men's bad behavior, which is insane, but if you point that out, you're accused of complaining. You're supposed to stay pretty for men, but not so pretty that you tempt them too much or that you threaten other women, because you're supposed to be a part of the sisterhood, but always stand out and always be grateful. But never forget that the system is rigged, so find a way to acknowledge that, but also always be grateful. You have to never get old, never be rude, never show off, never be selfish, never fall down, never fail, never show fear, never get out of line. It's too hard, it's too contradictory, and nobody gives you a medal or says thank you. And it turns out, in fact, that not only are you doing everything wrong, but also everything is your fault. I'm just so tired of watching myself and every single other woman tie herself into knots so that people will like us. And if all of that is also true for a
Before. We've got the SARS sitting next to the Jones Street Boys. We've got the Moon Runners right by the Van Cortlandt Rangers. Nobody is wasting nobody. That is a miracle. And miracle is the way things are. You're standing right now with 9 delegates from 100 gangs. And there's over 100 more. That's 20,000 hardcore members, 40,000 party affiliates, and 20,000 more not organized but ready to fight. 60,000 soldiers. Now there ain't but 20,000 police in the whole town. Can you dig it? Can you dig it? Can you dig it? gang could run this city. One gang. Nothing would move without us allowing it to happen. You could tax the crime syndicates, the police, because we got the streets, suckers! Can you dig it? For 10 square feet of ground. Our turf. Our little piece of turf. That's crap, brothers. The turf is ours by right. Because it's our turf. All we have to do is keep up the general truce. Take over one borough at a time. Secure our territory. Secure our turf. Because it's all our turf. Yeah!
spirit moves. The spirit moves is this film from late '30s, pre-war '30s, and it shows our fathers' fathers, you know, like the dancers before us. It really shows that we're all doing the same thing. All of this has been done before. We're just doing it in our generation. But a lot of this is just history repeating itself. That's what we are, the constant vibrations of the same. I started as a hip-hop dancer. I was a hip-hop dancer. And I wasn't a very good break dancer at all. I wasn't good at all. I wasn't good at break dancing. It's the pop and, you know, lock and stuff like that. But, you know, nothing to write home to mom about. You know, it was like just, I would say mediocre. I was pretty good. I won a couple of contests. I won even more battles. But, It didn't move me. It didn't stir my creative juices. So I felt that, at a certain age, especially after high school, I was looking for something different and a way to deal with my youth, you know, my youth in revolt. I was trying to figure out a way.